one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Tackle made there by Jabril Peppers.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. For 24 yards. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 46. On the handoff, it's Geis. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Minka Fitzpatrick made the play defensively, the first-round pick out of Alabama.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass.
Lucky 56.
To throw. And that is incomplete. The all-pro linebacker Luke Kuechly right there on the coverage, stride for stride.
All right, let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys, because the offensive guys always taught find the first down sticks and make the play. Well, on defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They were able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain of 39 that time. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make...
And the Redskins do get to him. He goes down for a sack.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Through the contact. Incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant to the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive.
Detroit!
Try and start this drive in the air. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And this will be caught at the 30. Big yardage that time for the Redskins. And even 50 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10.
Over.
On first down, this is Geis. He gets away from one. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Well, think of it like you would a typical boxing match. The person is on his heels and absorbing blows. It's having a tough time, and that's what's happening to the defense right now because the offense is on his toes and punching, and there was another first down run right there.
Redskins with their first trip to the red zone thus far. It's first and 10 at the 14. They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. And a stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
So first and goal and an opportunity for our first points in this wild card game. They'll try to run it. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. Darius Geis taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Redskins have taken a first quarter lead. Extra point splits the uprights. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. They'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at 2nd down.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney! Detroit! Detroit! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
He'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that one was nearly picked. Not sure he was accounting for the free safety. That brings up 3rd down. Pretty lucky to get the football back. Had his target out there waving the arms, saying I'm open, but maybe didn't see him quick enough.
And I know the jokes are always about defensive backs' hands. What really actually happens, you don't get many opportunities.
Detroit!
You get over anxious and you start to think about taking it away and going the other way instead of focusing and catching the ball.
They'll drop to throw. Throw left side, completion to Rice. And he makes it all the way down to the 31. A big 3rd down play there for the Niners. 43 yards.
Gone, gone,
he'll drop to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 18, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
They begin the drive on the ground with Mack. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Detroit! Detroit!
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Eric Armstead in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And he will be brought down, but he's got the interception on the final play of this first quarter. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Eluding the pressure. Couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Appeared to me he was just trying to find an open receiver and got forced out to his right. Had to come off of a guy downfield, tried to hit his back. Unable to connect. Should have been an easier throw moving to his right, though.
Yeah, much easier, obviously, for a right-handed quarterback. If he was going to his left, a little bit tougher.
Exactly.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Rice. That'll put him at 95 receiving yards now as he's got a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
But they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Now back to throw. And his pass incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8.
Gone!
Looking to throw. Being chased out left. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. They'll try the field goal now with Graham Gano. And Gano's kick is right through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they do get 3 points, but that's now 3 drives with only the 3 points, not a ratio that's going to win you many ball games.
Not at all, Brandon. And think about it this way. We all know payoff is the key, right? And wouldn't we love to have the concession on every T-shirt that's been printed in football that says finish on it? Because that's the mantra everywhere. Got to be able to finish drives, put points on the board.
Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. A run by Mack to start the drive. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90. Gone. Cut.
Back to throw. Incomplete.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. To throw. And the 3rd down pass falls incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And he's got his guys set up great now. First and goal. And the Pigs get at the 7-yard line. Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Now a run with Geis. He'll get 6 on the ground there, and it'll be second and goal coming up. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
Geis alone in the backfield here, second and goal. To him running left, and he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Darius Geis with his second touchdown here in this first half, and the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. And this one through the uprights and good. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. First throw for the backup, Jackson. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
And that's caught inside the 30. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. And that one results in 35 yards. They go play action here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
They'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Two minutes to go here in the first half. Back with more NFC playoff action after this. The Niners on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be a tough 3rd and 18.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll set up a throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
And Gano's kick is right through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
On play action, they'll throw. Throws right side, and that's complete. The 15 yards through the air and a first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Flush to his right. He may try and run for this. 8 yards that time. Able to take off, and the result is a first down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Steps away to his left. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. The Redskins on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This will be 3rd and 5.
Right, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Gone, gone. Gone, gone.
They'll set up to throw. Throw right side, caught by Davis. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Detroit! Detroit!
Back to throw now on first down. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded about a yard deep. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Here's second and 10 now from the 29. A play fake as they set up to throw. Buying time to his left. Now he'll throw deep, and he's going to be intercepted a third time. Monte Nicholson picks it, and he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. That had disaster written all over. You've got a right-handed quarterback rolling left and throwing it pretty far downfield.
It's really difficult to do, to try and get your body twisted around into the proper position and get anything on the ball as you heave it downfield. And that's what it actually turns into, a heave. And that's not really a good throw, is it?
Not good, and we saw the result. Whistles here before the snap. Was this on the Redskins? I think so. The false start backs him up five. First and 15. Play fake here on first down. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Akello Witherspoon. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Here's Jackson. He's going to let it go again. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. It got his man complete. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you...
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off around the 27, and they will take over at the 29-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to take another shot here. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. This one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at them and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Geis with the carry on second down. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a third down. Escaping the pressure. Now the ball comes loose.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass or run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. Here we go with Geis. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there, but they do convert on fourth.
Yeah, on fourth and inches, you've got to be quick with your decision-making when you're running the football. You've got to find the hole and go. And he does a nice job here picking up the first down with a few yards to spare.
Back to the ground on first. It's Geis. Oh, now he bowls him over. And he's got some space here. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Now a give running left is Geis. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. It was Jordan Evans making the play defensively.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And now he'll tuck it and run. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. The Redskins on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 9.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
They're going to look to throw. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first one, this from 44 yards out now. And his kick is good. And that will get the lead up to 14. Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little, maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he watched that
the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Over the middle, that's caught by Rice. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. That one goes for 36 yards. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Out to his left. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
All right, here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Again on second and 10, it's Jackson. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
On third down, Jackson. And that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play of the third quarter. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
All right, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Flushed out right. Now he'll, and this is caught inside the 5. And across the chalk into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. In for the score. And the 49ers have cut it back within a score. Extra point try good by Gadeau. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. That last touchdown has made this really tight. They're clinging now to this slim lead. Second half, they only have a field goal. This offense needs to kick it into gear.
And right now, I'm looking directly at the field general, at the quarterback. This, to me, he's got to take over right now by word, pumping his team up, and then, of course, by deed with his play. My school coach used to say that all the time. Laddie. Take over by word and deed.
And deed means action.
Exactly.
And the drive begins with a run by Geis. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Well, Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll look to throw now on first down. Looking left sideline, it's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
This quarterback now just 6 of 16 through the air, but he does have a first and 10 here. Geist receives the pitch. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Tackle that time by Jarquiski Tart.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. Again, they run. Again, it's Geist. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
The Redskins on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5.
Now let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
He'll look to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Darius Geis saving his best for the playoffs with his 3rd touchdown of the game. And the Redskins find a way to stretch their lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Eluding the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and ended up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown. And frankly, that should have been another pick right there. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Big tight end over the middle, Leopard, complete. Leopard. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes Leopard, for a first down.
Leopard,
now, correct me if I'm
Detroit.
Wrong. Yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And, like, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. In the pocket, chucked it away, flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field, have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
Back to throw here. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball. And they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. try it here. He's back to throw. Flush to his right. And no, it's incomplete. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Darius Geis taking it in from the 20, and the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. Well, look, this is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They had a fight and claw to win that division, but they're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like a statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game, a message to the top seeds. Overlook us at your own peril. We're pretty darn good.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down. That's just his second catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. They've done a great job of doing that.
He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down. And this will probably be the final play before the 2-minute warning. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this.
All right, now, lucky 56.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's going to let it fly. And my goodness, another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it, and the return will stop him well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy.
And he'll be wrapped up around the waist and pushed down. DeForest Buckner in there for sack number 85 of his great career, moving him past Hall of Famer Howie Long on the all-time list. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney.
Ah. Here's Geis, and an alley to run. And a nice pickup as this one gets him to the 10-yard line. It's a gain of 5, but they're still deep in a hole. 15 yards still to go on third down. He'll drop to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 45. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He can't avoid the pressure. Redskins get there. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And now here is another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it, and a big turnover there as his guys will get football back. Like he'll throw here. He's going to go up top again. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
And not much there as he gets it up to about the 5-yard line. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. The Redskins on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is 3rd and 8. Staying on the ground with Mack. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. And the 49ers going to take another timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Here's Tressway now as he's on to punt for Washington. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. It's taken on the 25. A good return there, 17 yards. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10.
All right, now look at 56.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to let it fly. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Odell Beckham, 58 yards. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. Gano the extra point, and that will get them one closer. So time definitely not in their favor. Down 2 scores, but they'll try the onside kick. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Looking to throw. Looking deep downfield. And this will be caught. We'll forget taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown.
Boy, that route is really tough to cover, because if they're running it correctly, you think it's really going to be a slam.
Yeah, well, we talk all the time about how it's tough to execute offensively, but you're saying, don't forget, it's tough to cover for the defense, too.
Yeah, the number one thing that you're taught is to not get caught inside or get beat inside. So you guard that a little bit more. So that gives you a little bit more space to operate outside if you start your move initially inside if you're a receiver.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. And I know it's hard to find solace on one side when the season ends, no matter where it ends, but especially in the playoffs, because there's all that build-up to the moment. But I would imagine the post-game locker room speech, it'll have a pretty positive spin.
It should. They've made a heck of a run to get to the playoffs.